Well, he was a world-renowned surgeon, and for his work saving the lives of heart patients, Victor Chang was much loved by all Australians. When he was cruelly gunned down in a Sydney street 2 decades ago, it was not surprising then that a nation mourned. Today, the man who shot Victor Chang was granted parole. While that's caused anger, it may not be where it ends.
As a cardiac surgeon, he was a pioneer, giving life to hundreds of sick Australians. His research helped save thousands more and in so many ways shaped the modern era of heart transplantation.
As a nation, we honour the memory of one of the greatest Australians of the 20th century.
Dr. Chang's death on July 4, 1991, draped a veil of grief across the country. His daughter told mourners the nation had lost not just a great humanitarian, but an elite surgeon who, when he worked, channeled a spirit that eclipsed even his own.
And I understand now, as I did at that moment, why they call Dad, why they do call him, a magician, a miracle worker, and a man who worked through God with his two precious hands.
Dr. Chang's life was snatched away in a suburban gun attack on a Sydney street. Chu Liew and another man, Philip Lim, rammed a car into the surgeon's Mercedes as part of a planned attempt to extort money. Dr. Chang took out his wallet, but in panic, Liew fired 2 fatal shots.
He was shot twice with a handgun shortly before 8 o'clock. The heart surgeon had apparently been involved in an argument.
Lim, who supplied the gun, was released in 2010 and immediately deported. Today, after 21 years behind bars and now suffering Parkinson's disease, Liew also secured his release, 5 years earlier than scheduled. The Chang family chose not to attend the parole hearing, but they were represented.
They are absolutely devastated by this outcome. They have absolutely no faith in the administration of justice in this state.
The Attorney General has sought urgent advice about the possibility of an appeal.
We tried hard to stop this. We fought against it. We didn't believe on the evidence available that there was any declining in health and that he should have stayed here. You can't kill great doctors in this society and expect to be released early.
The world continues to benefit from Dr. Chang's legacy. 5 years after his death, the Victor Chang Cardiac Research Institute was established in his memory, officially launched by Princess Diana.
That wonderful man did great things for humanity, and he is remembered with immense affection by his fellow Australians.
Let's hear more now on the impact of today's decision from Howard Brown from the Victims of Crime Assistance League in New South Wales and who is representing the Chang family. We saw him just there in that report. Howard, thanks for joining us tonight.
Pleasure.
You said outside court today that this decision had left the Chang's family in a situation where they've lost faith in the administration of justice in this state. They weren't expecting him to be freed?
Oh, most definitely not. He had not complied with any of the terms of his sentence. He had failed to participate in rehabilitation programs, and the family were well justified in believing that the sentence would be administered in the proper manner, and it hasn't been. Dr. Chang leaves a wife and 3 children and a number of grandchildren behind. The attorney said today that there's been a loss to the entire community, and that's true. But what we do tend to lose sight of is the impact that this has had on the family. They took some solace at the original time of sentencing that this person would have to participate in programs and do the right thing under the terms of his sentence, and so it gave them some hope. That hope was just torn away from them today, and so it's been like a double impact for them. They've lost their husband and they've lost their father, and now the courts have turned around and said, and we don't care.
Howard, the New South Wales government is seeking advice now about a judicial review of today's decision. In your view, are there grounds there for an appeal of this decision?
There's no doubt in my mind that there is. I believe that the authority made a number of mistakes at law in relation to what transpired today. They are required under the Crimes Administration and Sentencing Act to administer the sentence that was handed down by Justice Slattery. Justice Slattery made certain conditions for the prisoner to be entitled to release to parole. He has not satisfied any of those conditions.
For 23 years now, Howard, you've been representing victims' rights as a victims' advocate. How does this rank for you in terms of disappointment personally? Because you lobbied the parole board here by way of submissions.
When you get a case like this, which affected such a wonderful family, and we saw the death of such an esteemed person, I sort of took the responsibility for ensuring that that sentence was administered properly. And so I feel that I've let the family down. I feel a direct connection to Dr. Chang. And so I feel that I've let the community down as well. And so for me, this is one of the most devastating results I've ever experienced.
Well, you absolutely haven't let the community down or the family, Howard. This was a decision that was taken by the parole board. How would you like to see Dr. Chang remembered now? He's been remembered as an esteemed person within the medical sphere. How do you think his legacy lives on?
Well, fortunately, the Victor Chang Institute is still continuing to do brilliant work. Matt, one of Dr. Chang's sons, is still heavily engaged with the Institute, and I would like to see that that legacy continues. But as that legacy continues, I would like to think that every one of us, every member of the community, also respect the Chang family and realise that they gave up such a wonderful person. And that's one of the things we've lost sight of. People say that we cannot look at Dr. Victor Chang and say he is above everyone else. But we have to bear in mind that Liew picked Dr. Victor Chang specifically because of his notoriety. And I don't think that we can lose sight of that. That notoriety is what caused him to lose his life. And he gave his life to protect his wife and his family. They say greater love hath no man than to lay down his life. That's exactly what he did, and that's how I would hope he would be remembered.
Well, Howard, a decision by the New South Wales government on whether or not to appeal is expected within a week. We're very grateful for your time here this evening.
Anytime. Thanks, Matt.